I made this lovely little leather purse and got lots of compliments. One of my friends even said that it's absolutely the most beautiful purse she has ever seen. Well, it's unique, and I have never come across anything like it in stores. So I'm excited to show it off. I decided to publish this tutorial how you can make the purse because many of my friends showed interest. This charming purse is made from soft lambskin leather and is embellished with leather flowers, real pearls. It has nice shoulder straps and a classic metal frame closure. Inside it can easily fit a cell phone, wallet, car keys, compact mirror, and lipstick. It's perfect for a party, a wedding, or any formal occasion. Also, it can be a pretty gift. I like to sew with leather. Leather garments and accessories are always in fashion, but they are really expensive. If you make a skirt or a bag yourself, it will be much cheaper. The only thing you need to invest in is those luxurious skins. I think the only way to build your confidence in working with leather is practicing. I was inspired to create the embellishments by these Chanel and Fendi purses. Did you happen to notice the prices? If you make it yourself, it will not cost you an arm and a leg, right? To start, I would like to share with you some thoughts about sewing with leather. A few important things for you to keep in mind while you work with it. Leather is a wonderful material to work with, and it's easier to handle with proper tools than you may think. For example, lambskin leather is quite soft and lightweight, and it's not thicker than denim or upholstery fabric, so your home sewing machine can sew it without any problem. Leather doesn't fray, and because of this you don't need to finish edges. Leather is easy to cut and embellish. If cared for properly, leather will provide years of wear and your leather garments and accessories will look stylish for many years. All you need are a few special notions and tools and the courage to find a way around some challenges. I started to make the bag with creating a pattern that's suitable for the 8 inches metal frame I bought on Amazon. As you may notice, this frame has many small holes and has to be stitched onto the purse. Have in mind that there are other types of metal frames, and they can be attached to a bag differently. These metal frames come in many sizes, shapes, and finishes. I had to make my own pattern, so my purse will be the right size to fit the frame. If you buy the 8 inches frame, then you can skip this step and just print the pattern I made. You can find PDF on my blog. Sew a mock-up version of the purse from denim or upholstery fabric, so you know how it looks like before you cut your leather. The purse actually has only 4 seams to stitch, so it will not take a lot of time to make the mock-up. To prepare the leather for cutting, place it flat on a table and work on a single thickness. Check the skin for imperfections before cutting. I use sharp shears to cut leather pieces, but you can cut with a rotary cutter as they usually recommend for leather. You cannot use pins to attach pattern pieces to the leather because they will leave holes in the skin. Use pattern weights. in this case, to hold the pattern in place. I collected for many years real stone creations, so I use them as pattern weights. Use a pen to transfer pattern markings on the back of the leather. You cannot use pins because they will leave holes in the leather. So connect pieces together before stitching with office supply clips, paper clips, clothes pins, or these special clips I use instead of pins to hold pieces together. Set up your sewing machine for stitching leather. Teflon foot is really good for sewing leather on a regular sewing machine. It has special coating that enables leather to pass smoothly under the foot. Put stitch length to 2.83 mm. For stitching leather, it has to be slightly longer. Loosen the thread tension. I usually put it to 1. Instead of 3 or 4 for regular fabric. Practice stitching on scrap pieces before working on your purse and adjust the machine tension and the foot pressure. It's good to test how your sewing machine handles the leather. If you see that the sewing machine skips stitches, try to change the needle for bigger size. You can also use a walking foot. My sewing machine is Janome Memory Craft 6600 and it comes with AccuFit system, which is practically a built-in walking foot. You can use other types of walking feet working with different sewing machines. A regular sewing machine foot for straight stitching may work also if you have only 2 layers of lambskin leather. Don't backstitch. Just tie the thread tails because backstitching puts more holes in the leather. Let me give you some small tip about sewing machine needles. We usually use many types and sizes of needles for our sewing projects. For example, for this purse, I use leather needles of 2 sizes. So, what do you do with those needles after the project is done? I don't want to throw them away because I did only a few stitches with them. Two seams with size 90 and two seams with size 100. The needles are still good and I will want to use them for other projects as well. But how to keep them and know exactly what is the needle and what is its size? If there are marks on the needles, then it's easy, like with this leather needle size 90. But Schmidt's leather needle size 100 don't have any marks. So I mark them myself with a permanent marker, and after that I know exactly what needle I use. For sewing leather, I like to use very strong thread, polyester thread. Permacore, text 40. And this is the same Permacore, text 40, made in USA. The thread is so strong, I really cannot break it. Takes a lot of effort to break the thread. We don't usually use an iron for leather, but you need to open seams somehow without an iron. For this we use glue. I use this one, the ultimate. The only non-toxic water-based super glue. But I dilute the glue with water in a small container, half and half approximately, because it gives me time to work with it before it sets. Brush some glue mixture under seam allowances, finger press them open and tap to flatten them. The best adhesive everybody recommends is leather craft cement, but there are plenty of other kinds we can use. I use the ultimate, the only non-toxic water-based super glue. It has no odor, dries clear, and adheres to everything. I made a mistake in this procedure though, and had to redo it differently, which is a good thing, because I made all my mistakes before making the final project, and now I know what to watch out for. I got some dimples on the right side of the purse along the seams. I needed to redo that. So before putting the glue, you have to snip into seam allowances because the seams are curved. I didn't do it the first time. This was the mistake I made. Now let's make piping. Cut two rectangular pieces of different color leather for piping. 30 centimeters by 4 centimeters or 11 and 3 quarters inches by 1 and 9 16 inches. Piping is a nice detail for the sides of the purse. I used pink leather for piping. Brush the glue mixture on the leather strips. Place the cording on the leather strip in the center and fold the leather over the cording. Make sure that you put together the lengthwise edges of the leather strip. Seal edges as close to the cording as possible. Now you have 1 centimeter or 3/8 of an inch seams in your piping from where you joined your strips. Place piping around the side pieces of the purse. Cut piping seams 0.7 centimeters or 1/4 inch from the edge so you can curve your piping. Glue piping to the side pieces of the purse, only at the edges. Try not to glue the piping itself. With the glue, it will be easier to stitch around. Stitch with the sewing machine over seam allowances. Here I had to change the needle from size 90 to size 100 because I got already many layers to stitch. I had also to change the sewing machine foot to the zipper foot to go over piping. Now attach the sides with piping to the purse using clips. Stitch sides close to piping using zipper foot, sewing machine zipper foot, and leather needle size 100. Now, using glue mixture, attach side seams to the main body of the purse. I guess half of the sewing the purse is done now. So here I stop with this part and will continue the tutorial in part 2. By now I guess you see that you don't need any special training and equipment to sew leather.